encounters with these incredible creatures. No, that's not it. In truth, I was terrified. Weapons are born into existence when the planet is in crisis. When the survival of all creation is at stake. I hope you will forgive me my discourteousness. You came to me in good faith, and I turned you away. But we must face our fears. Only then can we hope to overcome them. And so I face mine. The weapons have come, and they portend a grim future for us all. A malevolent energy descended upon that life spring. Never in all my years of planetological research have I ever seen such a disturbing phenomenon. You, however, appeared unfazed by what you witnessed.
Yeah.
You needn't explain, Nanaki. Indeed, it may be best that you do not. The experiences of others may skew our own perception of the truth. For the time being, quiet observation is key to unraveling this mystery. In the grand scheme of both the planet and the life stream, the lives of us mortals and the sublunary parts we play are undeniably inconsequential. For our world is the accumulation of trillions of souls, an assemblage of all life that ever was and will ever be. But that is far too reductive a way to view the cycle which sustains us. We are, after all, a part of the planet. And the planet is a part of us, too. We mustn't forget that even the smallest of ripples can gather the strength to become the greatest of waves. It is thus incumbent upon us to do all we can in the time we are allotted. Do not die a ripple. I endeavor to do just that. I will continue to work to uncover the planet's secrets. And if I find anything, I will let you know.
All right, just try not to overdo it. For me?
Oh. Now, who could this be? Why, it's from a watchman in town. How odd. Oh, what did you say?
Is something wrong?
I fear there is. The survey team has returned with reports of sightings of key spirits within the veil.
But they were sealed within the cave.
Indeed they were. I can attest to that.
So how did they get out?
Well, these are spirits, Nanaki. Who knows what they can or cannot do? Though I know this is sudden, will you lend us your aid? Go and speak to the watchman at the gate. I will return to the Vale on my own.
We just got word from the survey team that they spotted the Gi right outside of town.
Yeah, I heard. Are they okay? They weren't attacked, were they?
Don't worry. Everybody's fine. Happened to be near the elevator, so they were able to escape in time. Though they had to leave their truck behind, unfortunately.
Okay, I'll go take a look. We can't let more into the Vale.
Appreciate it. Just, be careful out there.
Thank you.
place. Come on!
Tis him. Seto.
What? I'm not Seto. I'm...
Oaths of wretch. You think we shall be fooled again? Undying is our enmity. Here we shall have our revenge.
Far from over.
salvation.
What? I never agreed to that.
Do not feign ignorance, Seto.
Too bad. Take the lead.
You can do it!
Just what? Doing it! Look out! You got this!
My turn. Don't overdo it.
I'll show you what I can do.
Hang back. Take the lead.
I'll take care of him. Yoo-hoo! You'll see. Get him! You can do it!
Leave it to me!
Take it over.
Seto, I'm his son, Nanaki. There's a lot of things I don't know yet, but I want to learn. Can you teach me about my father? About you?
Your father. I see. As you wish, son of Seto. What would you like to know? Seto ventured deep into the caverns below your home that day. Alone, that he might persuade us to cease our ingress. Though we had braced ourselves for battle, we found ourselves captivated by his resplendent mane. He was a beautiful creature, in both body and soul. So swayed were we by his courage and sincerity, that we chose to entrust with him our singular desire. We desire the return of our black materia, and deliverance from this purgatory. We believed Seto to be a man of his word, yet his betrayal proved otherwise.
Our hopes placed in him, only to be trampled upon. We were forsaken, overcome with rage. One by one, our arrows found their mark, yet Seto was unfazed by our assault. As a confidant, our secrets he would keep. As a penitent, our vengeance he would accept. Yet Seto would not forsake his duty to keep us from the veil. He was resolute, his will adamantine. And with every arrow that struck, his body hardened to match his resolve before our very eyes, unmoving in the face of our relentless onslaught. 'Twas not long until we lost heart, conceding the futility of our plight, and sank back into the dark depths whence we came. Yet the darkness granted us no comfort, and certainly not the oblivion for which we so desperately yearn.
I know this might sound hard to believe, but I want to finish what my father started. I want to fulfill his promise to you.
Is that so?
And even if you don't trust me, Ginatok does. He asked me to get back your materia. Like I told him, I'll do everything I can to make sure you can rest in peace. All I ask is that you wait in your cave until I return.
And if we comply, you will keep your word.
It might take some time, but I'll do it.
Very well. Finally. At long last. And thus, the promise has been made. See that it is not broken, son of Seto.
You sure about this? They're gonna hold you to it.
And I hope they do. Dad understood the Gi's suffering, but he also understood others would suffer if the Gi ever got the materia back. He was willing to bear that pain for them, even if it turned him to stone, if it meant that he could spare others from their wrath. We just have to find that black materia, and we have to make sure that no one gets their hands on it, not the Gi or anyone else. But I do want to keep my promise. I'm gonna find a way to release them from their suffering. There's gotta be an answer out there somewhere, and I'm not gonna stop searching until I find it.
Oh, spoken like a true watcher.
You heard all that?
Our hopes and our dreams give us strength. Remember that. Hold tight to yours, and see that you never let them go. In time, they shall lead you to the answer you seek. Long has it been since I've spent this much time out and about. I'd best head home and rest these bones.
Hey! Welcome to Cosmo Canyon. May the blessings of the planet be upon you all, friends of Nanak.
What happened?
Wow. This is Cosmo.
Blessings of the planet be upon you. Are you in need of guidance?
Avalanche's crimes. There are wanted posters for them.
To think that such violence would be perpetrated under the banner of planetology, it turns my stomach, honestly.
Fellow Gugenhagen told us to leave them be. This is what we thought about. We should have done something.
Thank you.
Jack! What are you doing here?
It's good to see you too, Yuffie. And
who's this?
Helpless yet lovable minions.
It really is a small world.
Hmm? You say something?
Nope. Just glad you're okay. I'll be honest. When I first caught wind of Shinra's plan to drop the Sector 7 plate, I was pretty skeptical. But after you and I parted ways, I told HQ about everything I heard. Around making sure my friends got out in time. And most of them did. But not all. So many lives I could have saved. I'll never forget the sight of the plate crashing down. Gonna haunt me forever. I take it you tuned into Colonel Lodbrok's speech. It makes me proud to see folks finally banding together against that piece of shit company. Wutai is gonna be at the heart of this fight. And I'm ready to risk it all. To make sure we win. Nio and them? We were on the run together after we fled Midgar. They decided to stay in Cosmo Canyon. Said they wanted to brush up on their planetology. Though, I don't know how well that'll go for them. All three seemed pretty down. Hope they're okay. Actually, since fate has deigned to bring us back together, mind if I ask a favor? You see, I ran afoul of this big old fiend. I put the pedal to the metal trying to escape, and, well, now I'm paying the price. Pretty sure the sucker's still around here somewhere. Mind, smoking him out and taking him down?
A favor, huh? I suppose I could be persuaded, seeing as we are friends. But don't expect me to lift a finger for free.
Just name your price.
Got yourself a deal.
So how do we find this thing?
When it's not hunting, it's hiding. So it might be underground. But it should be easy to track down with one of those vibration detectors the Moogles sell at their shop.
Well, I'll be. Those pompsters have got it all.
You mean this?
Thank you.
projector ought to point you in the right direction. Just keep your wits about you.
Suki.
Come on.
Get ready. Here.
Thank you.
do this.
I can help too.
Kill. One more shot! Get him!
Okay.
Yeah! You've got
this. Right here.
Ready?
Let's do this. Freeze. Keep it together.
I'll take care of them. You'll see. Yoo-hoo! Here! Get ready. Okay. Go on! Yeah! Okay. Here!
Take the lead.
Leave it to me! It's over! Now, please!
Fight through it. Ain't dead yet.
End of the line.
Quite a performance. I'm impressed.
As you should be. So, where are you off to now?
Unfortunately, Shinra's been making moves to push back against the resistance effort. Once they tighten up the borders, travel's gonna get tough. So, I've decided to head for Wutai while I can. You're going home too, aren't you?
No, not yet. I can't. Not until I've gathered lots and lots of powerful materia.
I see. Well, try to stay out of trouble. That goes for the rest of you as well. You hear? You're bound to get caught up in the SRC's business at some point or another. Better be prepared.
Right.
I see in you. Good luck out there.
See you back in Wutai!
Port. About a particularly rare monster. Deep in the forest lurks a fiend so foul. pardon me. So foul, the mere mention of it induces nausea. This noxious pest may be negatively impacting the biome. I suggest you expedite its removal. And regarding your request from Kyrie, this expedition might yield some materials you require for the bait. One good deed could in turn help you carry out another. Isn't that great?
Square one. Huh? Who are you? Whatever, I don't have time to... That arm. That magnificent arm. It is a weapon. But how does it work? A universal adapter. Allowing you to switch out weapons at will. But look at all these scratches. Wait, have you been going around punching things with your attachments?
Occasionally.
Doing so ought to have given you multiple bone fractures. But this unique cylinder provides unparalleled shock absorption, allowing for high-impact performance. Who was the genius that built this?
An old friend, I guess. Don't know where he's at now, though.
Wait right there! Eureka! Sorry, got carried away. My name's Izo. I've been trying to create the ultimate weapon, but my attempts have all failed miserably. But thanks to you, I finally made a breakthrough. I must harness the inspiration while I can. Please, help me build it. Gather the materials I need. I'm originally from Junon, but I could hardly breathe there, so I decided to leave it all behind. I wandered in search of somewhere I could build my weapons in peace, and eventually, I wound up here. Not a bad place, huh? Of course, materials can be hard to come by when you live out here in the sticks. Though it seems crude at a glance, look close. The craftsmanship is remarkable. Whoever made it must have been a specialist in a completely different field. No mere weaponsmith would have been half as clever. Indeed, I've made it my life's work. Frustrating though it's been. How to conceive a weapon, I lack the vocabulary to describe.
Well, if all you need is some material, sure, why not? Just leave it to us.
Wonderful, thank you! I believe I left a map in my storage shed that you can use to find what I need. Grab that before you head out, and you shouldn't have any trouble.
Days?
If it ain't the present, it's the past, son. Must be the map Izo was talking about. Don't know what else it'd be. Well, let's see where it takes us. You ready?